The Bethlehem Icon Center launched a school to educate and revive the iconography in Palestine 70 years after this type of art faded. Icons, which are paintings that mostly depict religious images in the Holy Land, have become an integral part of the Christian heritage and culture.
The Bethlehem Icon School has been set up to train local Palestinians in their ancient Christian culture, which is icon painting. Okay, the point of the school, okay, is to enable people to paint icons, okay, not as a hobby, but as their career, as their profession.
According to iconographer Ian Novels, this industry has disappeared due to the lack of encouragement and support, and due to the low prices iconographers could get out of selling their icons to the Palestinian tourist shops.
And if you go to St. Catherine's Monastery in Sinai, which was part of Palestine in those times, they have the finest collection of icons in the world, and especially from the early period. So this is a very important part of Palestinian history and their culture. And there were icon workshops in Palestine until the 1940s here in Bethlehem. Now, quite why they closed, I don't know. But nevertheless, they were here. And they've been individuals still painting from that time, but it's individuals working on their own rather than really a workshop or a school of iconography.
The participants in this course said that it's a good opportunity to learn about the iconography and to revive this industry that flourished in Palestine in the past.
I always wanted to learn iconography because it's a symbol to our heritage and religion. Indeed, I am a university student and I spend my free time learning this kind of art. The iconography art started to disappear. In the past, there was schools that teach this art in the Holy Land. I have an old icon and I've been told that it is 200 years old and it was produced by an old school which was specialized in iconography here in the Holy Land. So there is a strong chance to give life again to this art.
For the owners of the tourist shops, they said that the icons are requested in the tourism sector, and that there are two types of icons. The old and historic icons that many of the churches in the world are seeking to retain back, and the newly local made icons that Palestinian artists produce.
This 18th, 17th century, 19th century. And now, Mother of Church of Russia, they like to retain back all these icons to Russia.
The school, presented by Novels, shed light on the importance of implementing the teachings of Christianity and giving workers the right in the profit. In this case, the iconographers only get $150 for their icons, while they are sold at $1,500 in the tourist shops.
When it comes to icons, you can see some examples here, which have been done by me and my students. Obviously, they sell well in the tourist shops. There's a market for them. But I think you'd know from your experience, the money that you can actually make as an iconographer isn't enough to raise your family. So, for example, one of my students, she'd done an icon of St. John the Baptist. That's him up there. And I asked her, well, how much would you be paid for this? And she said, oh, about $150. Now, this had taken her 3 weeks. And she has to pay for the materials out of this. So I don't know if you could raise a family on $50 a week.
The Palestinian iconography industry has disappeared, but this school hopes that this industry will continue to be a part of a just economy and a part of the Christian culture in Palestine.